In the port, I found Crest, the mechanic Katya mentioned before. He told me more about the local fanatics and promised to help us if we take him aboard. He is also heading east. The main problem now is crossing the bridge, as the fanatics that built their shantytown on it are very unlikely to just lower it to let the Aurora through. Still, I have a more pressing problem now. Anna went off the grid. I'm quite sure she's all right, but we can't afford to grow complacent here. The last time she used the radio, she was approaching a small hillock with some antennas.
Thank you. See how it all worked out?
Have a seat. Look, we have an opportunity to cross the bridge without an assault. There are trade caravans going up the river, and the bridge dwellers do business with them. So, disguised as such traders, we will infiltrate the bridge and lower it. Katya says it still works. They won't be able to stop us if we move fast. And should they try, we'll cross it no matter what those fanatics think. They want blood, they will get it. So now, we only have to wait for the traitor's port.
Colonel, sir, we can't just leave them here. They will be eaten alive.
Stefan, did you ever try using your head? Do you know where we are going? What we are going to face on the way there? Where, pray tell, are they going to sleep on the Aurora? Atop the coal crates? We Spartans can handle it. But for a woman with a 6-year-old daughter, no less, this is unacceptable.
I'll give them my bedroll and move into the stove.
You will fall asleep and get your throat cut the next day you get guard duty after trying to sleep there.
Still, I know we can't leave them.
Let's just collect that carriage Katya told us about while we wait. We can't leave the child here. And anyhow, how long are we going to sleep in turns for?
Are you starting that again? How? How are we going to collect that carriage? I'm not taking the Aurora there.
Oh, you don't need it. I have a railcar hidden in the terminal. It can tow a carriage like nobody's business. A German and I can go get it and bring the carriage back.
No way I'm letting you go. It will take us both till morning to finish the repairs, and I can't handle it myself in time. Okay, okay, have it your way. I'm done playing the monster here. We get that carriage. We take the civilians with us. Artyom, will you handle this? Listen, Artyom. If the caravan is sighted, drop everything and rush to the port. It's our best chance of traversing the bridge.
Thanks, Dad. Katya and Nastya will be so grateful.
Here, Artyom. It's a breaker for the rail car. It won't run without us. She's a real brave, Artyomich. No two ways about it. We went to hell and back, her and I. So much stuff, you all. So many tight spots she saved me from. Look, Artyom, since you're going to the terminal, hear me out. It's quite a distance away, and look, if you go at night, there's less of a chance you might run into bandits. They stay at their camps when it's dark. But it's not gonna be easy either, since more beasts come out, and there are also electrical anomalies. The fanatics call them the demons of electricity, so you should think about your options before heading out.
Artyom, Duke is on a mission in that area. He's keeping tabs on the bridge. Reception is bad there. We get mostly static from him. Anyway, if you meet him, he'll update you on the latest developments in the terminal. I bet you've conspired with Anna and Stepan. I care for those two no less than you. But we don't know if what's ahead is any better than the fanatics. I guess we'll have to live and see.